It's time for another node. Let's jump into Houdini together and check it out.
Vellum Strut Softbody. Vellum gives you a few options when configuring softbodies. Configure Strut Softbodies is the fastest to calculate as it creates a per point constraint, unlike the other methods which are volume based. This is useful as you can affect your softbodies per point using a Strut Softbody as opposed to the Vellum Balloon or the Tetrahedral Softbody. Let's take a look at how to set up a basic Strut Softbody and then we'll dive into some comparative examples and some other cool things that we can do. Let's drop down our favorite pig head. Let's turn off the material and we're going to subdivide it to get it just a little bit smoother. Then we're going to add a remesh to get uniform triangles. This makes the Vellum solver a lot more predictable. Next, we're going to add a Vellum Configure Strut Softbody. We'll then add a Vellum solver. Let's jump up to 4 substeps. We're also going to add in a ground position in the collisions tab and move it to be lower than our pig head. This looks great. Let's see what this gets us when we hit play. This looks cool. If you're like me, you're curious how this stacks up against the other softbody methods in Vellum. Let's do a quick test with all the settings set to default. As you can see, all three have slightly different results based on how the constraints are built. So depending on what you need for your project, each one has a different use case. Let's take a quick look at some of the settings that we can play with in the Vellum Strut Softbody. Until a recent version of Houdini where they introduced a new constraint called Shape Match, I found Vellum Strut to be the most stiff constraint, allowing you to emulate semi-rigid bodies. You could increase the stretch and bend stiffness and also add multiple constraints per point. This can still be useful to know and use, although if you have access to a later build of Houdini, check out the new shape match constraint, which is super cool and fast. You can also reduce the max strut length, so you only get struts in the parts that have small space between them. So now the middle of our pig head no longer has any support. Fun. You can of course also get the more classic type of softbody with really nice motion. Don't forget you can paint in a stretch stiffness multiplier so certain parts are stiffer than others. This lets you really art direct what you want. Now one of the major advantages of the strut constraint over the pressure constraint is that it is a per point, not a volume based. This means you can emulate inflation per point. Let's take a look at that. Here I have painted just the very tip of the pig's nose. I'm using this attribute to affect the P stretch's rest length. So let's compare both the pressure and the strut. Notice the strut constraint only inflates the nose where I painted, whereas the pressure inflates the entire pig head with more volume. Here's another example that shows this. I have a sphere which I have squashed. I've added a Vellum Strut softbody and in the cloth I lowered the stiffness so each polygon could stretch as it expands in the struts. I also reduced the bend so I could get some nice wobble and in the struts I only added a P stretch group and left everything else at default. I then used a very simple expression to create a mask covering half my geometry. I then promoted my attribute because constraints work on primitives. I then used 2 primitive wrangles. The first is to set the rest length of the P stretch group. The second is to set the rest length of the bend and stretch stiffness. Now when I hit play, you see that only half my sphere is inflated. Fancy. A great use of the softbody strut setup is if you want to do a shrink wrap. The reason this works so nicely is that as you shrink the rest length of those internal struts, it maintains the overall shape and integrity, but it gets smaller and wraps nicely around an object. Let's take a look at this setup in more depth. We'll start with our pig head. This will be our collider. We'll keep it at default. We'll just subdivide it. Next, we'll add a sphere. We want the sphere to be bigger than our pig head and roughly centered around our pig head. Next, we'll configure a strut softbody. In the cloth settings, we'll just reduce the bend stiffness slightly so each polygon can bend and wrap more easily around the pig head. In the strut constraint, let's change the stretch stiffness to 1000. We'll also output a P stretch group. Let's add a Vellum solver and give it 4 substeps. We'll remove gravity. Now we want to dive inside the solver and slowly reduce the rest length. Otherwise, it'll snap to the desired amount on frame 2, and that isn't exactly what we want. So let's dive inside. Here I set up Vellum constraint properties. This is because I want to affect my strut constraint and my cloth constraint separately. So in the first Vellum constraint property, I'm only affecting the bend and the stretch. I animated the rest length scale from 1 to 0.55 over 30 frames. On my second Vellum constraint property, I'm affecting my P stretch group. I'm animating the rest length scale from 1 to 0.45 over 30 frames. Now when I hit play, we get this really nice shrinking behavior. If we add a Vellum post-process, it smooths it out nicely, giving us a fun look. As always, Houdini gives us a variety of cool ways to make the fun things that we love to make. So why don't you give Strut Softbody a try? It's Houdini time.